Agricultural of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, we thank the Lord. Now let us look into our Bibles. The book of 1 Samuel.
And then
chapter 16.
And then
verse 7.
We'll read verse 7. And then
if we found it.
It
will be read as follows.
Morena a sevela Samuel ar. O se bona se bopa o sa gagwe le botelele bya gagwe. Nna ke monyaditse ka gobane yo batho ba mmogelago ga se ena. Motho o bona se se lebanago le matlo a gagwe, morena yena o bona pelo.
But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looked on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. May, let us pray.
Retse ba go tsore a di di atenja motho a nge a rata go ba ke a kitimela di matsong a ga o ge wena o rata go ha buela motho ya le lentsu she le modimo re le ba di le re le go pela le papa le matla o tle re sho fa le jelo na o re thuse mo lona re di kwele papa le matla o there go le ile me weng ya re sho fa tsa mero ka moka sho fa tsa tshotle le le mele sa tlo bolela go se ba matla o tsara tsara tlhaloganya motho.
Amen. Child of God, we are thankful. This afternoon,
we are
going to talk about what we have read. That the Lord seeth not as men seeth. Amen. We as people, we have our own way of seeing things.
And then,
and we judge them.
While
God also has his own way of seeing things.
And then,
in the manner that God looks unto things,
you'll
find that the ways of the Lord is against our ways. Because the ways of a man, it looked at the outward.
And then,
but the Lord, in accordance to what we have read, he looketh on the inward, in the heart. That's what the Lord is doing.
And then
I said to people, we have our perspective ways of seeing things. While God has his only way to look at things. God looks on the heart. We as people, we look at the stature of a man and also look at the things that he possesses. We look at whose child is he belonging to. We look at this person is in his life. What is it that he can help us with? Because we are looking at his outward. But God, he looks at the heart of the man and he works upon the heart. Should he find that the heart is not right, he changes it and give you the right heart. Even today when you want to work with a man, it's still his responsibilities to change him so that this person can suit the standard. That's the way as children of God. It is very important to seek God. Because God is the one having responsibility about the life of a man. So where we have read, it was required that there must be a king. That king
is
the one to rule people. You know that the Israelites reached a point where they wanted Saul to be their king because they looked at his stature.
They
say he was a tall man of a great stature. They looked at him that this man can complete the work. But when God looks at his heart, see that this man will not complete the work. But his condition passed. Came again that there should be a right king. That king, his name is David. David also, he had his brethren. His brethren also are older than David. David was a young man. When looking at him, he did not qualify to be a king. But before God, he qualified. Because God was looking at the heart of David. But then they brought forth the brethren of David, his elderly.
Yes.
When they brought them forth one by one, God was telling Samuel that this is not the right one. Let him pass.
They
come another one. Say, let him pass. After all of them, seven of them has passed. But God, when he was looking, he saw that they are not the right ones. He asked that, is there not anyone?
He said
he's still young.
And then he's
still heading. They say, fetch him. When he came forth, God saw that this young man, I can work through him. God told Samuel that there comes a king of Israel.
He's
the one that you can anoint him with the
oil.
Indeed, David was anointed. But looking at David, he is the man that when looking at him, you will not take him as a king. Because when you look at him, he was just a young man. But God knew it very well that even if David is a young man, but I as God, should I dwell inside his heart, David will be able to complete my work. That's the way God requires. God wants himself to dwell in the heart of a man so that he can complete the work. Not a man who should work for God, but God should work for himself inside a man. That's the way children of God, we must check things. That as children of God, let us realize very well that God, he has his own way of working things. In the manner that people are looking at things, God does not look at them the same way. Even if you can look at a man, you despise him. But be careful that you do not disrespect God. Because God, he works in simplicity. He works in simple things. The things as if they are useless. That's how God works.
And then
I've said, we have a way of looking at things. And God also has his own way of seeing things. So a man looks at the outward, but God looks at the heart. We people, we look at something and we judge it in the way that we see it. Let me give an example. It's like when someone is married, there are certain things that he is looking for. That is in a human way. He might look at the beauty of the person he's going to marry, looking at the smile of the person that you're going to marry. But God, he does not look at the smile. He does not look at the beauty of a man. Because he knows that the beauty vanishes.
And then the smile is always kind of fair.
Also, the smile vanishes.
Really,
but God, he looks at the heart. Because in the heart, he knows that the character is there.
If
you reach a point,
we
see a man must reach a point of getting a character. Should you get the character of someone, is where you know that a character does not get old. The character does not vanish because it's the character of that person. When we are talking about a character, in fact, we are talking about the real person. It's like if someone can get married to a rich man,
and then look more affair,
the rich vanishes. But what requires? It requires a character. That even if the riches have passed, but the character remains standing. Even if the beauty can fade away, the character will still standing. Because the character is from the heart. But the things that are looked by a man, he looks at the outward appearance. That's why I say God look at the heart. Because in the heart there is a character. But what can we learn out of this? As people, we must learn and know very well that us, where do we allow God to work? Or how do we want God to work with us? We often hear God says,
He's
able to change a heart of a man, a stony heart, and turn it into a heart that is flesh. Amen. He gave a man a good heart, a soft heart, a heart that can build. Because if you can have a stony heart, you will have a problem. So God, he wants to work with us from the heart. Because the heart is the one that has everything. In the heart is where things are at. The heart, it has contained everything. Even if you can hear someone say, I do not love you, should he speak that from his heart, you will even feel that this person does not love
you.
But should he say he loves you, coming from the heart, you will follow him. You will see that this person indeed is telling the truth. That's the way people were looking at things. But I am pleased by this matter of God, that he saw David, that he is the one who qualifies. But should you take David and take him to people,
and
then you put him amongst well-educated people, you put him amongst the people who had many years of ruling,
and then
the kings of that time, David did not qualify, but he only qualified before God. Even you and I, times we might pray that the world you are living in, when looking at you and see that you do not qualify, but don't be troubled that you do not qualify before people, because before God, should you qualify before him, you are a privileged one. Because people, they might ordain you today, tomorrow they chase you away. Because they chose you looking at your appearance. But God, because he chose you from the heart, there is no day that he will chase you away. That's the way that when you pray, when you are a child of God, you must worship rejoicing, knowing that I have accepted God in my heart. And the matter of the heart, it becomes a beautiful one.
And then
it sits there.
And then
being a matter that comes from the Lord. And the true matter is in the heart. Outside there, there is nothing that is real. The true thing is inside, it is invincible. You might pass it and fail to see it. When you saw taking Jesus, crucify him, they failed to see the inside of Jesus. Should they see the inside, they should have accepted him so that they can see inside him. Just like Peter, when he looked at him, he did not look at his physical appearance, but he was looking at the inward, looking at inside. When Jesus said, go away, the one who does not eat my flesh and drink my blood is not part of me. Other people, they went away. It was because they looked at the way he pronounced things, looking at the outward. But at the depth of a matter, they failed to see. Others, they remained. It's for the likes of Peter who remained.
And then Peter,
when Jesus said to them, why don't you just go away? For the likes of Peter said, Lord, where will we go? Because the ways of life are with thee. Because when Peter was looking, he saw that there is no other way that has eternal life other than the one that are upon this land. Even today, children of God, there is no man of worship. There is no life other than taking God by the heart. You might pray. You might sing the choruses. You might preach. You might do everything. But inside the heart, it depends on what it is.
Inside.
Should we find your heart being empty? Not as who are judging you. But your heart is the one that judges you. You are the one who is able to feel that your heart is empty. Because even if you have done wrong,
and then you
don't even see wrong. You see yourself being right. Even if you can wrong someone,
and then
you don't see that as a mistake. But should someone do wrong unto you, is where people are able to see. But here we're talking about a child of God who is able to see things like his father.
And then
because God, he has his own way of seeing things. He does not see things the way that we see them. The real matters in the heart. People, you might tell them lies, but you cannot lie to yourself, because your heart is the one that knows very well the condition that you are in. You might tell all the people all the other things, and they listen to you. If they vote for you, they will do so. But deep inside your heart, you are the only one who knows that even if they can vote for me, when I go from here, I will do nothing to them, because the heart tells you, and you will never deceive your heart. Amen. The heart is where lays a character of a man.
fail.
And the character does not vanish. That's the wisdom of God. We must know that when you're a child of God, you must know what you are. So the work. Should you work the work with your heart?
And then
they say the work will not tire you. When you see people are always tired, there are people who are working the work not by the heart. They work with their carnal mind. That's where you see people at workplaces. He will just touch there and there and he will just sit down. Say that I did not pay me. I openly ask myself there, what doest thou there where they do not pay you? It is better to go away. I'm trying to show the matter of the heart. That should you complete the work by the heart, you will work very well. When you see there are a lot of theft in this world, when you see there is a lot of destruction, it is because people that did not do the work by their heart. If you can look through the government, look inside the churches, look at the schools, you can even look everywhere. People that did not work their work through the heart, they just go there with their carnal mind. That if you tell me this way, I will respond to this way. But the one who works wholeheartedly, he does not approach anywhere with reasons. He does not have reasons. He knows that I'm here because I'm looking for a way. So I found the way. So is for what's for me is to
wait.
But when you see people are always tired, it is because in the heart there is no work.
And then
the work
and then
start from the heart and comes outside and see the hands operating
and then
completing the way.
And then
they say the power lays in the heart.
And then
the one that loves the
world.
When you see people powerless, instead of picking up something, say that I cannot. It is because in him or inside the heart, he does not have power. He has nothing inside the heart. Should he contain something in the heart, that person will do things right. Even in life, inside the heart of a man, there must be a hope. When you see people without hope, it's not a carnal thing, it's not an outward thing, but it's a matter that must be inside the heart. But should God pronounce something for us to trust in him, we must trust in him from the heart. Should we trust him with our heart, we be able to work with God and be able to continue. But when you see people going up and down, the prophet says, why are people tossed about?
And then
this day they are this side, the following day the next side, because they do not have hope inside them. Because hope is something that comes from the heart. Should it dwell inside the heart, there is no one who can remove it. And the tactics of a victory
are
inside the heart. The heart is able to tell a person mighty things. That's the wisdom of God we must be. That our hearts, when they treat God, they must take him in his greatness. If we have sicknesses, when he said that we will be healed, we must take him the manner that he pronounced
it
and take him from the heart and accept him inside our heart, so that the word that he utters can take us to somewhere. God bless us. Why do you see us people failing? People fail because they do not take God from their hearts. They take him from what they see. For an example, should someone stand up here and walk while he's disabled, all people will clap their hands. But should someone be saved from within, because they do not see him, they will say there is no just a person in this world, because this one, he is saved, but they do not see him. They want the one that they see, that indeed he is walking right, so that they can explain about him that this person was disabled. So today he is walking upright. They want things that they see, but God requires the inside of a man. He works inside the heart. It is like joy. Should they say someone is joyful? You do not just see you dancing, going up and down, and see as if that you are rejoicing. When you are full of joy, you might sit there and keep quiet. But then inside the heart, there is joy. In the manner that is joyful. You see that the better is just to keep quiet. That's the way a child of God is. That's why even the Bible says, a merry heart healeth the body. If your heart is heavy, it's able to heal your body, because the heart is full of joy. You might think, you might look at things the way that you see, but those things cannot help your body. But if the heart is joyful, even if the veins of the heart, when it is busy pumping the blood, the blood flows in the right way, because they flow rejoicing. When you see people with the high blood sugar diabetes, it is because inside their heart, when the heart pumps, it pumps full of anger. But yesterday, that person was dancing right there and seeing as if he's happy. But sometimes you find that he's just crying. He knows that he has a problem, but the problem that he has, he does not know how to solve it. You take as if that one is busy dancing, he might feel something happening in his heart. But when you say that you are rejoicing, you rejoice from the heart. Should your heart rejoice, it healeth everything. You will just sit there, child of God, and know what you are, and you know that you are a child of God. There is no joy other than the joy from the Lord. When you see people in the world trying to serve the Lord, let us serve him with our hearts, not serve him with our carnal minds, because we will miss him if we use our minds. God bless us. You might work the things in the manner that you do, but you must do them wholeheartedly. When you see people failing, it is because they look at the station of a man. We are talking about a king here, that Israel, in the manner that it takes things, it will suffer. Should it see God, God will give them the right king. Even us today, there are a lot of things that we might look for, but let us seek them looking at what the Lord says, that the heart of God, what does it say? When he looks at our hearts, does he see truth inside? Amen. So a perspective of the Pharisees, when they looked at Jesus, they looked at
at him in a manner of despising him. They looked at him in a human way. That whose child is he? What is it that they possess in his family? How do they live? In the manner that they live, it is not the way that you will accept them. Even Jesus, when he was there, he wouldn't accept them because he came from a poor family. Let us look even at the prophet. You might not look at him in the right way because the family that he was born in, there were many.
And then
even him, he was born in there. He had a problem of that family. He had his problems. But when he said there, God wanted to use him and took him outside, out of his brethren. So even you today, God is able to take you out of your brethren because he's looking at your heart. Should you realize that God is looking at my heart, you will serve him rejoicing. Because you can see that he chose you because of your heart. When you say the heart get in hand with God, the prophet says, when you are born, you are born when you have something inside. And that thing only awaits to hear the word of God. After he hears the word of God, the very same thing that is inside you, it rises. That's to manifest that I am not ruled here, but I have a place where I am ruled at. Let me give you an example. The prophet usually tells us about an eagle.
And then really
that he once laid eggs.
And then
a farmer came and take the one of the eggs and put it with the chicken eggs. When he put the eagle egg with the chicken eggs, that egg of an eagle, when the eggs of the chicken hatched,
and then
even the eagle one hatched, they grew. But that eagle, he had a problem. He was not told by anyone that you are not supposed to eat this way. It was not told by anyone that you are not of this place. Inside this eagle, it was just shocked. It has its own way of hearing things. That I am dwelling here, but this is not my place. I have a place where I must be at. One of the days, they say the eagle started to realize that the egg that I laid,
and then
the egg, it has hatched. And this eaglet, there must be another eagle somewhere because of the egg that was taken.
And then
it went out. It went out for hunting. It started to cry out. When it is crying, the eaglet with the cheeks started to hear that I always had something inside. The one that told me that this is not my place, so I am going away. When it started to,
and then it
started to fly,
yeah,
and to follow the cry,
and
the shout, and then it went away. On the ground, the talkings remained.
And then
the cheeks started talking. Even if he lives that way, but he must know that he is groomed by us. But what remains, that eaglet, he had something from within. So even a child of God, when you pray, you do not just pray because you are supposed to. You must have something from within.
the
one that leads you to prayer.
And then,
should you have a character,
and then
you will never change that
character.
Let me give you this. A frog one day, just dwelling there. When dwelling like that, a scorpion sat on the opposite side. Want to cross the river. Saying that if he can try to cross,
and then
it will drown.
And then you are like scorpion.
The scorpion requested the frog. Can you please carry me to cross to the other side? That frog spoke to the scorpion. You are dangerous.
And then
you will bite me, not
scorpion.
The scorpion say, relax. You are talking about old people. We are just people now. We do not even have a problem. We are no more biting anyone. The frog was convinced. Listen to the words of the scorpion. They say, now get on my back.
And then
the frog crossed with the scorpion. When it crossed to the other side, when reaching the end, the scorpion bit the frog.
And then,
why did you bite me?
I don't know.
In fact, I, my work is to bite
you.
Because inside me,
like in scorpion,
I am a scorpion.
And then
I'm not the way that you take
it.
Even if someone can tell you something,
do
not listen to what he tells you. Look at the character of man. Indeed, is it correlating with what he says? You see that scorpion? Now it brings forth its true colors on the other side. So when you're a child of God, you must be what you are in accordance with the word of God.
You say,
in the heart of a believer,
and then,
even in the heart of God, it is like an office. It's where things come out. God, we cannot work with him if we do not believe him with our heart. For you to work with God, you must believe him wholeheartedly. I'm saying heart is the office of God. If you are here on this world, if God wants to work the things of this world, he dwells in the heart of a believer so that he can operate the things of this world. If he wants to heal the sick, he must dwell inside a man. If he wants to help people, he must dwell inside the heart of a man. That's the way God works in things. So that he can distribute things. So that he can reach the people who are in need. The Bible says, people praise God by their lips, while their hearts are far, far away. You see that the heart of a believer must be near God so that he can work with God. When you are sick, should you believe wholeheartedly, is where you will get healed. When you see a lot of people, they are prayed for here. Tomorrow they are prayed for. The other day will be prayed for. They are always running. But when a child of God, should you be prayed for, you do not change the place. Because you realized very well that this place is the right one. This place, I believe it with my heart. You are no more being pulled by any spirit. Amen. So to say that you are healed, you must be healed from the heart. You know, if the heart can be healed, you are completely healed. No more sick, saying that here and tomorrow there, because inside your heart, you are completely healed. And the problem of a man is the things that comes from the heart. Inside the heart, should the heart bring forth the wrong things, the evil things, is why you have a problem. Amen. You must have a right mind. And you must also have a right heart. So that you can bring forth the right things. If the heart cannot be settled, the body will be restless. If the heart can be filled with fear, the body also will be filled with fear. Because the heart is scared. So when you're a child of God, you do not rejoice because you have money. You do not rejoice because you have riches. But you sit there. You believe God with your heart. And you know very well that inside my heart, I rejoice over the word of God. I believe in the manner that God has said. There is nothing that can disturb me. Because the joy comes from the heart. So all these things in of God, I'm trying to show you here, that children of God, the way that we look at things is not the way that God looks at it. We have our own way of seeing things. In the manner that we see them, at the end it leads us astray. But should we have the eye of God and see things in the manner that God sees them, we'll be able to continue and be able to rejoice, be able to praise God, knowing very well that our God is able. And a prayer of a believer availeth much, because it comes from the heart. Should the prayer comes from the heart, you get settled. After you have prayed, you are able to feel that you have spoken to the Lord, and the Lord will answer. So with these words of God, I say, let us be watchful that when we do things, let us seek God with our hearts. Should we seek God with our hearts, we'll be able to continue, because this God, he requires those who seek him with their hearts. I'm telling the truth, you know God. Should you not serve the Lord with your heart, you will always be tired. The things of God you will never do
better.
Instead of praying, you'll find yourself tired. Instead of reading the Bible, you'll find yourself tired. Because the heart is the one that is tired. Inside the heart, let's say in the heart there is no
God.
But if God is inside the heart, you will be willing to serve the Lord. Everything. You want to see yourself being able to do
it.
Because inside your heart, there is something. Something that encourages you. Something that makes you to see. And you rise up. You go and seek because of something that is inside your heart. If your heart contains nothing, you'll just sit there with a lot of doubt. You see, a man after God's own heart, one day when he met Saul, inside him, he saw that I will kill this one. Because his heart, he saw that it is courageous. But when you look at the likes of Saul, they were sitting there filled with fear. Because inside their hearts, there was nothing. But David, the one who had the heart of God, he was able to stand. He saw very well that the manner that I'm in, because God, I am with God, the things that I'm doing, God supports them. Today, the very same man, he will not see the sun setting. I will kill him. That's the way children of God. David won. He was despised. But he had the heart of God. Because when God was looking at him, he saw that this one can be able to save him. God bless you. Let us all close our hands. Modimo Hoshira Matlaotle, Reahole Watati. Obane Mukawena Hoshi Awana Tati.
Yes.
le modimo ka lentjula ha o le le boletse mantsi bane nga le tjaji re thoma o elela re khosi ya ka re motho a sna tlhao ya hao a gona le se se treta te sa ka go direla sona more khosi re a khopela tate ramatsa o tlo re lentjule a nke go wena o le phidishang ka mara dipelo tja rena go shimora na modimo re tsebe papa o le rena ka mogore lebelelang dilo ka gona a se ka mogo wena o bona dilo ka gona more re be le phelelo dipelong tja rena kgosi ya ka tjao ba le leitlho la gago la go lebelela dilo ore dinakong ka moka kgosi ya ka se wena tate o nyakang re se bona re kgona o se bona kgosi
yes
ka gore modimo ke dumela gore tate he re ka lebelela dilo o yala ka mokgo wena o le lebelelang ka ona re ka seka ra faila le tjatji le ka le le tee morena ka goba re wena kgosi ya ka o modimo yo a sa palelweng ka dinako ka moka e batho ba lwala kgosi ya ka o a ba fodiša e re na le mathata tate o a rarolola morena e kgosi ya ka o e na le tlhakatlhakano kgosi ya ka wena o tiša order morena jale modimo he re ka ba le pelo kgosi ya ka e kgokaganeng le pono ya gago kgosi ramatla otlhe re ka palelwa jwang kgosi ya ka gore le di-intentions tja rena kgosi ya ka e taba tja gago morena jale kgosi ya ka lentšu la gago le le boletse mantsiwaneng re a leboa tate re ranke le felegetso kgosi ya ka ke maatla a le godimo maatla moyo mokgethwa maatla kgosi ya ka a o phedisa kgosi ore bo botlhe ba ba theleletseng fa kgosi ya ka o be le se se phedisiwang ka mogare ya pelo kgosi morena modimo ka moka re be le phelelo kgosi ya ka ya go ba le leitlho la gago kgosi ya ka re a go leboa tate go ba le mo metlheng ya bofelo o sa bolela ka batlhanka ba gago kgosi morena modimo ke se shupo kgosi ya ka sa o bontsha gore tate wena ga ka wa homola kgosi ya ka o sa bolela le lekgono morena wa rabile dipuso tse be re na le tsona mo dipelong kgosi morena modimo ka gobane wena kgosi ya ka wena wa kgona wena o palele ke selo morena tsho go fa ja bo botlhe kgosi ya ka ba ba theleditseng molaetsa o kgosi morena modimo ba tsho go fa ja e re mo ba tlhokang wena kgosi ya ka o ba fe kgosi morena modimo ba ba tlemilweng kgosi ya ka set them free my heavenly father through the preaching of the word ba kgosi tate ramatla otlhe ba na le mathata le ona ba rabolela ona kgosi morena modimo gore all the glory the honor the adoration kgosi ya ka diwe mo go wena morena leina o phagamišwe la gago jeka moka kgosi morena modimo re gafela matsong a gago re tshapa re dumela mo lenele le phela la morena Jesu Kriste re a leboa amen.